Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss about the non-destructive tests conducted on the hardened concrete. So when I say the non-destructive test, so here name itself indicates that non-destructive means it is not destructive, it is not demolishing the materials of the hardened concrete. As we are doing the destructive tests like the compression test, flexure test, where using the compression testing machine we are destructing the we are demolishing the concrete cubes or the cylinder for calculating the strength of the concrete or the properties of tensile strength of the concrete, compressive strength of the concrete and all, right? So here in non-destructive test we are not going to demolish or we are not going to break the structures for calculating the strength. So these are non-destructive tests generally carried out over the existing buildings or old building for calculation for considering the for knowing the strength of the structure, structural strength like compressive strength, properties of the structures like that. For that purpose we go for the non-destructive test. So generally non-destructive method have been used for about 4 decades. In this period, the development has taken place in such an extent that is now considered as a powerful method for evaluating the existing concrete structure with regard to the strength, durability, apart from the assessment of the control of quality of hardened concrete. So this is the quality of the hardened concrete is the main part here. In certain cases, the investigation of the crack depth, that is a major point, and macro cracks which are present in the concrete structures and the progressive deterioration. So these all can be calculated using the non-destructive test. So here, for calculation of the crack depth, macro cracks and deterioration, as we have explained in the previous videos, so these all are the they are reducing the lifespan of the concrete. So when they are reducing the lifespan of the concrete, in that means they are reducing the strength of the concrete. By doing this non-destructive test, we can calculate what will be the properties of the concrete structure, which is available older structure which is constructed previously. So depending upon that, we can study about the study and analyze about the properties, and we can also go for the, if we want to rehabilitation or we want to make the any repair work, so in that case it will be helping for the construction work. So non-destructive testing methods are relatively simple to perform, but the analysis and interpretation of this test are not easy. Therefore, special knowledge is required for analyzing the such types of values which are coming from the non-destructive test. So yeah, that is what the first thing, and also it is a cost effective one. It can be applied for the both new and older structures and determine whether the structure is suitable for design use. That means if you want to construct for the one more story, or if you want to add the more load to the existing structure, in that case whether the structure is going to take that load or not, it can be calculated by using such types of tests. Okay, in this non-destructive test we are having STT, that is semi-destructive test, and NDT, that is non-destructive test. In semi-destructive test, a part of damage can be done to the structure but not totally destroyed. But in non-destructive test, we are not doing any damage to the existing structure. This is what the main difference between the SDT, that is semi-destructive test, and non-destructive tests. Okay, where we are using this non-destructive testing to determine the parameters like density, elasticity of elastic modulus, strength, surface absorption, and location of the cracks if are present, which are going very far inside, prolongated, or joints are properly prepared or not, and if concrete structure it is a honeycombing, it is there or not, to determine that and determine the position of the reinforcement where it is placed and what are the reinforcement to have placed, diameter of the reinforcement and how far, how inside, what is the cover it is given for the reinforcement, it can be calculated, and quality control of the construction, for checking the quality control, it is also an important method, and confirming the workmanship. That means when doing the concrete compaction or not done or not properly. So for all this purpose we were using the non-destructive test. So in this non-destructive test there are many methods or many instruments are used for the non-destructive test. In that, for visual testing, right? Second is skimmed rebound hammer test for surface harden testing, ultrasonic pulse velocity test, that is for the compression strength, permeability test for flow of water, half cell electric potential method for the corrosion testing for the reinforcement, and radiographic testing for detecting the wires which are present in the concrete, carbonation depth measuring for determination of the corrosion of the reinforcement, impact echo testing, ground penetration radar testing, infrared thermology. So these all are the different methods of different tests which are carrying out in the for the non-destructive test. In that we mainly use skimmed rebound hammer test and ultrasonic test for the compressive strength and surface hardening tests of the concrete, because these are the main preliminary tests we are conducting in the test. And in this video we are going to discuss about the skimmed rebound hammer test and ultrasonic pulse velocity test. When any person want to go for the such types of testing, so they have to check for the organization who is conducting the non-destructive test, has to certify from the ISO 9712, and all the clauses, whatever the test which are conducting, so it will be on the with respect to the IS standard 1311, where all the non-destructive tests which are as were explained in the previous slide, so all are mentioned in the IS code, and according to this they have to follow through this. And for ultrasonic pulse velocity test we have the 13311. This is the IS code part 1, so where it is properly explained, and they have to go through the guidelines of the IS code. And for rebound hammer test we have the IS code for 13311 part 2. So this is the for rebound hammer test. First one is rebound hammer test. This is used for measuring the surface hardness of existing concrete mass with the in terms is correlated with the regard of concrete. So it is mainly used for getting the surface hardness of the concrete. Along with this, we can also calculate the compressive strength using the surface hardness of the concrete. And here we are, for calculating this compressive strength, we are using the calibration curves are available. Calibration curve, that is graph is available for calculating the compressive strength using the rebound hammer test. In this graph we are having the rebound number, so whatever the number it is indicating to, from this rebound hammer test, so that it is represented in the x-axis, and compression test which is indicated in the y-axis. So this test can be, in this graph we are having the wets for calculating the wet surface and dry surface. Whether we are conducting this test for on the wet surface, surface it is wet or dry, so depending upon that we are having the different lines or different lines on the graphs. And in this, again we are having the three lines for each. So one line is for this Ribbon-Dammer test can be used except horizontal direction and as well as in vertical direction for upward and downward. For these three, which are indicating that the first one, which is indicating the vertically downward direction, and last one, that is second one, which is indicating for the hammer, which is used for calculation like this, as the for horizontal way, and third is for the upward direction, for needle is pointed upward direction and it is pressed like this. We can also for these three conditions, there are the different three graphs. According to this, we have to go for this, and whether the whatever the number it is there, if I am having the 20 rebound number on the rebound hammer test, according to this, we have to first see that whether the surface is dry or wet. According to that, we have to go for this, and along with this, on which direction we are pressing the hammer, whether it is in a horizontal direction or vertical upward direction or vertical downward direction. According to that, we are using this graph, right? It can be best used for the compressive strength of one's concrete against the other. That is, for comparing the one concrete to the another, for calculating the compressive strength, it can be very easily used. And moreover, each hammer varies considerably in performance and require the individual calibration. That means, for the same point, if I am pressing for the two, three times, we can get the different reading depending upon the where it is hitting and depending upon the calibration of the hammer. And original schematic skimmed hammer impact direction perpendicular to the surface used for the concrete or the mortar testing. And in next level, silver skimmed hammer independent of impact direction, suitable for testing a wide variety of the concrete and mortar and also rock for the calculating the compressive strength of the compressive strength. And this is the quick and simple and less expensive, because at an instant we should not wait for the 28 days for curing for the normal compressive test carried out in the as per the destructive test method, right? This is as hardened concrete it is there, just we are using the hammer test, using the hammer we are just taken the impression of the how much impression it is getting or what the number it is doing giving the for calculating the compressive strength. Depending upon that, we can easily calculate. So that's why it is a simple and it is a very quick method for calculating the compressive strength of the concrete. Next is CL. In this diagram, it is showing the different parts and how it is present in the schematic diagram of the our skimmed hammer test, rebound hammer. Here in this skimmed rebound hammer, it consists of a spring. This is a spring controlled over the mass that slides on the plunger. So this mass, it is moving from this sliding over this plunger, and it is having the one spring, and it is mass, and it is having the plunger that is at the this one at this front plunger, and here we are having the release button for the whatever these readings which are given in the scale, it is reverse scale, it is there at the top. So whatever the reading it has given, right, when it is pressed or when the rebound is taken place, so this needle or this rebar will be moving from the depending upon the impression or depending upon the force which is moving. So according to this, it will giving us the reading. So once this moving pressed, so at that time we have to press it and we have to lock this rebar so that we can check or we can note down the reading properly. When plunger is pressed against the surface, the concrete spring controlled for the controlled mass rebound. That is, when it is pressed against the wall, so spring which is controlled over the mass, it is rebounded. So like this, it is plunger, it is there. When it is pressed it like this, so this is spring, it is rebound, it will be take place, and when it is from top to bottom again, it will be moved. At that time, our rider will move over the slide over the scale. So at that time, once this it is moved, we have to lock it for the noting of the noting the rebound readings. So here, this test having the certain limitations, as whatever it is reading we are getting, it is having the accuracy for about a variation in the result for 20 to 25% with the accurate actual compressive strength result the effect of angle test. So sometime what will happen when we are testing the testing using the rebound hammer test, it will be not be exactly perpendicular to the surface, so it will be some inclination will be given, and if smooth surface it is not there, and mixed proportion, these all are the limitations. Only suitable for the closed structure, that is concrete structure, it is not suitable for the hollow structures. And rebound hammer have to be calibrated frequently. That means this hammer has to be calibrated frequently. At certain time it has to be calibrated. And the test results are depending upon the moisture condition of the surface. Wet surface produces the lower rebound readings up to the 20% of that produced by the same surface of when it is dry. And surface carbonation, if it is surface is carbonation it is there, in that case rebound hammer number will be increases. And location of the plunger, where we are placing or where we are pressing the plunger, whether it is hitting on the directly on the aggregate or the mortar surface, so depending upon that it is giving us our readings will be varying. Next is our pulse velocity method. In this method is used where we are calculating the time of travel of the pulse of vibrations of ultrasonic ranges passing through the concrete for judging the quality of the concrete, workmanship of the concrete, and the structure wires are present. So depending upon that, for calculating all this, we are using the pulse velocity of the method. So it can be operated in the direct, semi-direct, or indirect method. So in next slide, I will show that. The results are mainly depending upon the heterogeneity of the concrete within a shorter length and presence of the reinforcement of the steel or other impurities which are present. So what we are doing, presence of the reinforcement or any other impurities which are obstructing the pulse velocity, and it is increasing the time taken, and used to judge the uniformity of the concrete to establish the acceptance criteria for correlation with the strength is possible. So here in this diagram, where it is showing, this is a direct transmission where this transmitter and receiver. Transmitter is what it is doing, it is transmitting the waves, and receiver it is receiving the wave. So these both are placed on the opposite surfaces. This we call as direct transmission. In semi-direct transmission, this transmitter and receiver are placed on the two surfaces that are which are perpendicular to each other. Or we can say that on the both side by side. And this here on the same surface, here where transmitter and receivers are placed, and our surface waves are received from the this type of transmission. Here in the from all these three we can direct transmission test, it will give the better result for the compression test and the other tests which are carried out by this. Long here what we are doing, long waves travel twice faster than the as the other. Surface waves are the slowest. As we are saying that this long waves are traveling faster twice compared to the other waves, and also surface waves, that is from here to here, this we call as surface wave, it will be lowest one. So that's why we are considering this is the better one. Here what we are doing, time travel between the initial point to other point, we will recording it electronically, and also what is the distance traveled from one point to other point, that is calculated, and path length is noted down. According to that, using the formula, we are going to calculate the different strength or test compressive strength and all. Okay. So here in some factors which are affecting this ultrasonic test are smooth surface, smoothness of the concrete surface under the test, influence of the path length and the pulse velocity, temperature of the concrete, moisture condition of the concrete, and presence of reinforcement. So if presence of reinforcement, as we have explained, these all obstructing the waves, and moisture content which are increasing the time length and all. So for these all are affecting the test for the giving the accurate results. So here determining the quality of the concrete, as we are getting these results, 4500 ms meter per second, it is an excellence, and if it is our results are within the 3500 to 4500, it is a good, and if it is 3000 to 3500, it is durable, doubtful, and it is 2000 to 3000, it is a poor. So like this we will calculate, or we can indicate the structure, and determining this setting characteristic, durability, study of freeze, so freezing action, thawing action, and attack of chemical attacks get out can be studied, and detects the cracks which are present in the concrete surfaces, measures the deterioration of the concrete due to the fire exposures. So all these aspects we can calculate using the this test. Okay. So this is what about the non-destructive tests which are conducted in the concrete structures. Okay. Thank you.